We will discuss about the all pair shortest path in this lecture. The all pair shortest path is about finding out the shortest path between every pair of the vertex. It means if this is the network or the graph, and 1, 2, 3, 4 are actually representing the stations, and you are interested in finding out the shortest path between 1 to 2, 2 to 1, 2 to 3, 3 to 2, 3 to 1, 1 to 3. Similarly, 4 to 2 and 2 to 4. That means you are interested in finding out the all pair shortest path. So, for finding out the all pair shortest path, we need to apply an algorithm that actually checks the distances between the pair of a station via other stations. It means at one point of time, I will take this one vertex as a mediator. And we'll find out if the path via 1 is minimum. For example, if I want to go from 4 to 2, the direct path from 4 to 2 is suggesting a 16 distance. But if I go through 1, so 4 to 1 and then 1 to 2, then the distance becomes 3 plus 9, that is 12. So I will follow this path. Similarly, some of the path may be shorter by taking vertex 2 number as a mediator. Then similarly, some of the paths will be shorter. For example, if I want to go from 2 to 4, so the direct distance between 2 to 4 is 20, but if I follow the path 2 to 3 and then 3 to 4, the distance becomes 12 plus 5, 17. So I will follow this path. So I will take every vertex as a mediator at one point of time, and then we'll update the distances. So suppose we have a weight matrix for this graph. So the weight matrix of this graph, 1 to 1 is 0, 1 to 2 is 9, 1 to 3 is 0, 1 to 4 it is 0. If there is a direct edge, I will write the distance of that the direct edge or the weight assigned to that edge as an entry to the weight matrix. Otherwise, I will leave that 0. So from 2 to 1, it is 0. 2 to 2, it is 0. 2 to 3, it is 12. And then from 2 to 4, it is 20. From 3 to 1, it is 0. 3 to 2 it is 0, 3 to 3 it is 0, and 3 to 4 it is 5. From 4 to 1 it's 3, from 4 to 2 it's 16, from 4 to 3 it's 0, and from 4 to 4 also it is 0. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 entries. So let us count the number of edges here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we have made all the entries in this weight matrix. Now I'm going to compute another matrix, that is D. This is a distance matrix, and there will be some of the updations here. For example, if I cannot reach from 1 to 4, so I will consider that the vertex 4 is unapproachable for 1, meaning that 1 to 4 entry in the distance matrix will be infinite. If I cannot reach from one vertex to the other one, I'm considering that distance as infinite. So 1 to 4 entry will be infinite. Obviously, if I'm going from 1 to 1, that means I'm going from that station to itself. Okay. So 2 to 2, meaning that vertex to itself. So every entry which is 0 here in this weight matrix, that will be set as infinite, leaving all the non-zero entries as such. So we are making an updation. And let's say this is the T0 matrix. Fine, this is showing the direct distance between a pair of vertex. Then what we will do, we will take vertex number 1 as a mediator. We will take vertex number 1 as a mediator and we'll update all these entries. Suppose I want to find out path from 4 to 2. Fine, 4 to 2. And the mediator vertex is 1. So what I will go do, that I will go from 4 to 1 and then 1 to 2. For this particular graph, I will consider this D0 as a base matrix. 4 to entry here says it is 16. 4 to 1 entry here is saying 3. And 1 to 4 entry, it is infinite. Sorry, 1 to 2 entry, it is 9. So 3 plus 9 is 12, which is shorter than 16. So I will update this distance. So meaning that if I'm going to find out any Dij entry, let's say I'm going to find out any Dij entry, then maybe that this Dij, let's say this is the ij entry. So maybe that this Dij entry itself is smaller. Or if it is not, then I will, let's say this vertex number 1 is some mediator k. So I will go from this I to k, and then I will go from this k to j. In this case, this is I, this is j, this is k. So I will go from I to k and then k to j. I will add these two distances. So either this will be smaller or this will be smaller. So I will select minimum of these two. Fine. So either this is smaller or this is smaller. And about the matrix, that let's say this is D1 matrix. So for finding out the entry in the D1 matrix, I am considering that this D0 matrix is the base. So if I am going to find out a DK entry, then this value will be DK minus 1, means the matrix and matrix that I will be referring to will be DK minus 1. Fine. So for finding out the D1 matrix, I am taking this D0 as a base. So the formula for us has been, I am writing it again, DKIJ. I am interested in finding out this IJ entry taking vertex number K as a mediator. Fine. After finding out this D1 matrix, I will find D2. What will D2 be referring to? D2 will be referring to the matrix which is in which vertex number 2 has been taken as a mediator. I will consider that I have found all the distances taking vertex number 1 as a mediator earlier. So I will be referring to that matrix as a base. So for finding DK matrix entry, I will take DK minus 1 as a base. So DKIJ is equals to either IJ entry in the K minus 1 matrix is minimum, or I will go from I to K and then will go from K to J and will select the minimum of these two. Fine. So let us find out the D1 entry. There is a shortcut. If I say that all the entries here in this graph are positive. So if all the entries here in this graph are positive, all the weights are positive, then we can apply a shortcut that if I am finding the D1 entry, then the entries in the first row and the first column will remain unchanged. Fine. So the entries in the first row and the first column has remained unchanged. I am not touching these entries. This is because, suppose I am finding D1, let's say this entry 1-2 entry. So 1-2, for the 1-2 entry I am taking one number as a mediator. So either 1-2 is minimum or 1-1 plus 1-2 is minimum. So in the first term wherein it is direct, and the second term wherein it is indirect through one more vertex, both of these are containing 1-2. So if both of these are containing 1-2, that simply means that I am adding something to it. Means 1-1 is added to 1-2. So obviously it cannot be minimum. So that's why this first row and the first column entry has been made unchanged, remained unchanged. Now let us find this entry. This is 2-2 entry. So I will find 2-1 entry and then 1-2 entry. 2-1 entry here is infinite. So if it has come infinite here, and then 1-2 entry is 9, infinite plus 9, obviously it will be infinite, so no change here. Similarly, 2, 3 entry, 2, 1 and 1, 3. Since 2, 1 always is coming infinite, so obviously there will be no change here. Let us find out this entry, which is a 3, 2 entry. So 3, 1 and 1, 2 entry. So 3, 1 here is infinite. And then 1, 2 entry is 9. So I'm adding infinite plus 9, it will be infinite. So it will remain infinite. Then let us find 3, 3 entry. Again 3, 1 and 1, 3. 3, 1 is infinite. So again 3, 1 is coming. So no change. And then 3, 4. Here also 3, 1 is coming. So no change. And then for this one, this entry, this is 4, 2 entry. So 4 to 1 and then 1 to 2. 4 to 1 is 3 and 1 to 2 is 9. So 9 plus 2 is 12, which is less than 16. So I will update this entry. And this is 4 to 3 entry. So 4 to 1 and 1 to 3. 4 to 1 is 3 and 1 to 3 is infinite. So there will be no change here. For this entry, 4 to 4, I'll find 4 to 1 and 1 to 4. So 4 to 1 entry is 3 and 1 to 4 entry, it is infinite. So 3 plus infinite, no change here. So there is only one updation here. Now I will be finding the D2 matrix. For finding of the D2 matrix, second row and second column entry will remain unchanged. And I will now take D1 matrix as a base. Let us find out this entry. So this entry is 2-1 entry. Sorry, 2-1 entry. So either 2-1 is direct, which is infinite, or 2-2 and 2-2-1. Second row is this one. So entries which will remain unchanged are this second row and second column. I'm not touching these entries. I'll find out these entries, remaining entries. So this entry is 1-1. So 1-2 and 2-1. So 1-1 directly is infinite. 1-2 is 9. And 2-1 is also infinite, so there will be no change here, it will remain infinite. This entry is 1-3, so 1-2 and 2-3. 1-2 is 9, and 2-3 is infinite, so no change here also. 1-4 entry, so 1-2 and 2-4. So 1-2 entry is 9, 2-4 entry is infinite. Again, infinite plus something. No change here. I am going to find this entry. This entry is 3-1 entry. So 3-2 plus 2-1. 3-2 entry is infinite. What 2-1 entry? It is also infinite. So no change here. It will remain infinite. This entry, this is 3-3 entry. So 3-2 and 2-3. Infinite. And 2-3 entry is also infinite. No change here also. This entry 3-2-4 entry. So 3-2 and 2-4. 3-2 entry, it is infinite. And 2-4 entry, it is also infinite. 3-4 was already 5, so it will remain 5. This entry, this is 4-2-1, 4-2 and 2-1, 4-2 entry, 4-2 entry is 12, and 2-1 entry, it is 9. So 12 plus 9 is 21. So here already we have 3, so it cannot be updated to 21, it will remain 3. Now this entry, which is 4-2-3 entry, 4-2 and 2-3, 4-2 entry is 12, and 2-3 entry, it is infinite, so this will have no change. Similarly, for this one, 4-2-4 entry, 4-2 entry, and then 2-4 entry. So 4-2 entry, it is 12, and 2-4 entry, it is infinite. Again, there will be no change. I'm adding infinite to something. So in the similar way, we have updated the entries of the D2 matrix, keeping second row and second column unchanged, and then I have found the entries of this table. For D2 matrix, D1 matrix is taken as a reference. Then again, for finding out the D3 matrix, the elements of third row and third column has remained unchanged, and I have taken the base D2 for computing the D3 matrix entries. Similarly, I have found the D4 matrix, taking vertex 4 number as a mediator, and then this D3 matrix is taken as a base for finding out this matrix. So this way we were able to find out the D4 matrix, which is the final matrix, which is telling us the shortest distance between the pair of the station. So if I mark the vertex number here, so this entry is telling us the shortest path between 1 to 1, this is telling us shortest path between 1 to 2, 1 to 3 and 1 to 4. 2 to 1, 2 to 2, 2 to 3 and 2 to 4, 3 to 1, 3 to 2, 3 to 3 and 3 to 4, 4 to 1, 4 to 2, 4 to 3 and 4 to 4. Fine. So now let us write the algorithm for the same. The Poisson algorithm is very, very simple. We are taking the base of the matrix here. So this is actually the Floyd-Warshall algorithm. And in this Floyd-Warshall algorithm, there is a weight matrix given to us, which is a 2D matrix. And the number of vertices, let's say, n is the number of vertices. So the weight matrix is already given to us. I will form a D matrix, which is a distance matrix by this. In the weight matrix, some of the entries were 0. Where there was no direct test, those entries were 0. I will make them those entries infinite. So for I equals to 1 to n do, for j equals to 1 to n do. I is referring to the row number, j is referring to the column number. For updating the matrix entries, I need to have I and j both. So what we will do, if wij is equal to 0, then dij entry in that will be set as infinite. Otherwise, dij entry will be same as that of the wij entry. Having done so, we will now update the D matrix, taking every vertex as a mediator. So I have to update every entry of the matrix for I equals to 1 to n do, for j equals to 1 to n do. So this nested loop is ensuring that I am looking at every entry of the matrix. Now I will take every vertex as a mediator and will look for all the entries in the table, all the entries in the matrix. So outside this, I am taking another loop. So for k equals to 1 to n do, every vertex will be taken as a mediator at some point of time. So having taken one as a mediator, I will compute all the entries of the matrix. Having taken second number vertex as a mediator, I will look for all the entries. So here the formula will be, I have to find the dij entry in the matrix, and this will be minimum of dij itself or dik plus dkj. So I will find out the minimum of these two and will set that as dij. Fine. So now this d is actually our answer. So finally I will return this d matrix. This is an algorithm, so let me write a keyword algorithm here. I am beginning and here we will end. So in this you can see that we have first set the dij entries. So those entries of wij which are 0 as set as infinite, otherwise they will remain same as that of the wij. For every vertex, we will take that as a mediator at some point of time. Taken 1 as a mediator, I will compute all the entries of the matrix. Taken 2 as a mediator, I will compute all the entries of the matrix, and so on and so forth. So we are taking as many variators as many as the number of the vertices in the graph. And finally, D is telling us the shortest distance. Thank you.